guys, so today's video is going to be a get ready with me for school. A foundation primer so that your foundation stays in place all day long. So I'm going to use the Benefit Professional. For foundation, I'm going to use my NARS Sheer Glow. I'm in the color Mont Blanc, which is really, really light. It's so weird doing videos on YouTube and having to like think about everybody's schedule because I don't go back to school until tomorrow, which is September 2nd. But I know there are some people who have been in school since like August 2nd, and it's just so weird to me like how different parts of the country can do that. I would hate going back to school in August. I feel like that's prime summertime. Like, why would you do that to anybody? Next is concealer. If you're waking up super early and going to bed kind of late, you're probably gonna have some dark under eye circles that you want to go ahead and cover. So I'm using my NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. Bring this below my eyes, anywhere I have darkness or redness or acne, anything at all I need to cover. And you want to make sure and set it with a powder, especially if you're gonna be at school for a long time. So I'm using the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder and a big fluffy brush. I'm just gonna bring this basically all over my face, and especially right beneath my eyes where the concealer tends to crease on me. I personally like to go for a full face of makeup every day at school. I know some people will say that's way too much, but you know what? Makeup is your own business. It's nobody else's business what you put on your face. So I like to contour, highlight, everything like that. I just think that I spend the majority of my time at school anyway, so why not? Why not? So for contouring, I'm gonna use the Benefit Hoola Bronzer in this contour brush from Sonia Kashuk. Side note, this brush was literally like $3 at Target, and it is the best contouring brush that I've ever owned. It's just wonderful. So I'm gonna take a little bit of this, and I'm just gonna contour my cheekbones and the sides of my face. I'm not gonna worry about my nose today just because I don't feel like it. But just again, really wear whatever makes you feel comfortable. Like, it's so, the makeup shaming thing that has become kind of a new, I don't know, trend, I guess, is just, it makes me so sick. Like, it's nobody else's business what you put in your face. It really is not. Like, you do you, it doesn't matter, and as long as you're comfortable, that's really all that matters. So stop telling other people what to wear or what they can't wear or what they should wear. I don't agree with it. So everybody make your own choices, and like, I don't know, just be happy with it. So as you can see, I'm bringing this around my forehead because I like to contour my forehead a little bit, because my forehead is a little bit on the large side. As I've gotten older, like, everything sort of evened out in proportions, but I still like to contour a little bit, and then just a really light contour below my cheekbones. For blush, I'm going to use MAC Dainty with a big fluffy brush in a little bit more of a line shape than a dot shape. You see those tutorials where it's like, you know, smile big with your cheeks and just place it on the apples of your cheeks. But I think that look makes you look a little bit, it lets you blend it super, super well. It has the tendency to make you look like a clown. So I like to bring it in sort of a line from the beginnings of my cheek, I guess this is just your cheek, back to almost my temples. And I blend it in a lot so it doesn't look like a streak of color. So as you can see, my contour is really, really light. Like, you can hardly see, you can't really see the color at all. It's just sort of a hint of a shadow, which is what I want it to be for this look. So I'm using my Urban Decay Primer Potion. This is literally what I use in every single tutorial. I'm gonna be using my Urban Decay Naked Palette, and I'm gonna start with the color Half Baked, which is a really pretty light gold color. I'm gonna bring it on just with this little standard medium shadow brush. I'm gonna bring this all over the lid, and it'll look kind of crazy at first, but we're gonna blend it out and we're gonna cover it with more shadows later, so don't worry about it. You just want gold all over your entire lid, basically. For Smog, which is a darker, oh, slightly gold tone, but mostly just brown. I'm gonna be putting this on the outer half of Buck, which is a medium toned brown, and it's matte too. I'm on a MAC 224 brush, which is a big fluffy blending brush, and I'm gonna bring this through the crease, and this will help everything come together, blend in, and also deepen up the eye quite a bit. Now the color on this eye got a little bit muddled, so I'm going to use a clean blending brush. This is the MAC 217. This is a trick that you guys can use anytime you feel like your makeup or your eyeshadow has gotten a little bit out of control, just to blend it a little bit better and make it all look a little bit better. I'm going to take this and I'm just going to blend out the crease some more here. This is just going to move the color. Since there's no color on this brush, it'll just help diffuse it a little bit better. So for liner, I'm going to use MAC Coffee Liner. This is the dark brown color. I'm going to bring this on my waterline and tightline. Lining your tightline and waterline is such a good trick for school if you want minimal makeup, because it's going to intensify your look, but you can't really see that you're wearing eyeliner. Take some more of this same coffee liner, and I'm gonna smudge it on the outer half of my top lash line. This is the MAC 219, it's just a little like domed pencil brush, and I'm gonna use a little bit of the first color we put on our eyes, the Half Baked, the light gold color, and I'm gonna use that on the inner half of my inner half of my lower lash line. So I'm just gonna dab it in to the gold a little bit, shake off the excess, and then just really carefully apply it from my inner corner to the halfway point. And that just adds a really, really pretty accent to what you have going on top. On the outer half of my lower lash line, I'm gonna use the color Dark Horse, which is a shade darker. These are all shadows from the Urban Decay Original Naked Palette, by the way. But this is a dark brown, a little bit of shimmer in it. I'm gonna add quite a bit of mascara on my top and bottom lashes. I'm gonna fill in my brows just to the point of not having any bald spots, as you can see. I have quite a bit of like just random bald spots right here in this brow and down here in this brow. So I'm not gonna like make them too defined, I just want to fill them in a bit. To highlight, I'm gonna use my Too Faced Candlelight Glow Highlighter with a fan brush, and I'm just gonna hit this on the tops of my cheekbones. Mostly just there, honestly, I'm not gonna highlight too much. For lips, I'm using my YSL Rouge Volupt number 7. This is a really, really pretty soft pink color. As you can probably see throughout the video, my hair dried just fairly wavy on its own. I really like that, so I'm actually only going to do a couple things. I'm gonna do a deeper side part. I'm just using the base of this comb here to bring it through and make a side part over this way. You could do it either way, it doesn't matter. Either side. And actually, I'm gonna do the other side. I like it better on this side. Just kidding. You wanna bring your hair over, and this side part doesn't have to be super clean either. It can be totally messy. I just like it because it gives your hair like more volume on that side, and you can just sort of like rough it up and nothing really happens to it. Like, it just looks good kind of no matter what. So I'm gonna make this a little bit more precise and just play with it till you find a part and like a preciseness that works for you and your hair type and your face shape. See, this is like really poofy right here, so I want to bring that down by just kind of roughing it over with my hands a bunch of times. So for my top, I'm just wearing a dark denim button-down from Forever 21, and I'm leaving this a little bit unbuttoned. This necklace is from a store called Happiness Boutique. It is the Opalescent Statement necklace. I am absolutely in love with it. Happiness Boutique is a really, really cool jewelry online retailer that ships worldwide for free, which is incredible because, as you know, probably if you've done any online shopping, hardly anywhere offers worldwide shipping for free. Like, it's really, really difficult to find free shipping, and it's awful when you find something and the shipping like costs more than the actual piece. So they offer free shipping worldwide, and they also have a rewards program that you can use to rack up points, and you can end up getting a free gift of your choice from their website. So I'll have them linked down below if you guys would like to go check them out. I would highly recommend picking up a statement necklace or two for the school year because it's so easy, well, if you're running late or you're running short on time, to just grab like a jeans and a t-shirt and throw on a statement necklace and look a lot more put together than you actually like put time into. I turned the fan because I was dying of being too hot. But so there's a lot of options you could do to style this. I have this long sleeve rolled up denim button down, and I actually have a pair of a skirt right now, which I'll insert a picture of here, but you could do it with some jeans, some black jeans, a different kind of skirt, a colorful skirt, really anything that you wanted to. This is a really, really pretty look. Just, it's super, super diverse. Throw on a statement necklace, throw on a basic top, you're good to go. If you like this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to go check out Happiness Boutique. I will have them linked in the description box below, as well as this necklace specifically. Don't forget to subscribe to see more videos like this and lots of other types of videos too. As some of you may know, if you follow me on Twitter, which I will also have linked below, I am starting a new uploading schedule of every Friday at 7 p.m. Pacific time. So that's like California, Washington, Oregon time, along the West Coast, basically. So every Friday at 7 p.m., there will be a new video here for you to watch. I'm gonna stick with that for a few weeks, maybe a few months, see how that goes, and maybe we'll add in Tuesdays too. So if you wanna have more updates like that, make sure you follow me on Twitter, which is at Miss Ella Rose, and there's an underscore there too. It's at Miss I think it's at Miss Ella underscore Rose. I'm gonna have it written down right here because I don't even remember my own handle. And also on Instagram at sparklesandsuch26. I hope you guys are having a fabulous day, and I will see you next week. Bye! I'm sorry if I seem uninterested, or I'm not listening, or I'm indifferent. Truly, I ain't got no business here, but since my friends are here, I just came to kick it.
yourself not